So you got to see a corner of my kitchen and the decor and a wood bookcase also that we've pulled out and are no longer using for our pantry. And this beautiful new cabinet to us is what we're going to use. And you're just going to see right now the things that I have placed in there. There's no rhyme or reason and no organization as of yet. I've got some new containers I'm going to be filling. I need to just figure out how to make this work for me. I also have a turntable with canned goods and I just can't figure out what I want to do. So I am in the process with excitement, having fun, creating a new pantry in my kitchen for myself. And it's just been really enjoyable and also a learning lesson. What works for me, what doesn't work for me. So I've got things pulled out every which way. So enjoy just seeing the rest of this. Here's just another quick view of this bookcase. I kept my cookbooks on the bottom and the food and the breads and things like that were on the rest of the shelves, but honestly, it just did not work. I loved that the top opened up on it, but it was time to pass this on and we are presently selling this on Facebook Marketplace. I did have these large glass jars that I'm going to be using these to fill. I already have some of those in my pantry that I vacuum sealed with my food saver product and I really like it. You can see me at one point holding up a jar and you can see the seal is on that. So I probably will be doing that with some of the extra flour and things that I have too. Back at the Stockpile and Pantry. Now you got to see in the beginning of the video, a nice snowy day here in New Jersey. We have layers of slush, snow, ice. It's just this, it keeps coming in layers. It snows, then it rains, then it's a wintry mix, then the snow comes back and so on. So that's supposed to be about 2 to 3 days worth. We're about halfway through it. We'll see what happens. Then you got to see some of what I'm doing. So I am updating my pantry and my kitchen. It was not working for me. It was not working. I tried it for about a year and I had an old bookshelf. I don't really have a big kitchen and the cabinets that I have, I need for my appliances. Don't have a lot of room for food, but I wanted to, you just have to try things until they work. I watched other people, how they set up their kitchens and their pantries and their stockpiles, and I tried to mimic that. I've always had a small kind of pantry stockpile, but I wanted to go bigger. I wanted to get a little bit better and a little bit more elaborate for myself. And nothing I did this year, there were pieces of it that worked and there were other pieces that didn't. So I had this bookshelf and you could see I could lift the lid and I could store stuff and so on, but it just was open and exposed and the way it just didn't work. It just didn't work and I didn't like it and it was annoying me. So it's like, take time out here. If it's annoying you and it's not working and you're the one running your kitchen, move on and find something else. So we decided that's what we're going to do, and we started looking and pricing things. We looked around at several thrift shops, and we couldn't find anything. Nothing at all. There were no shelving units or, I mean, other than large dining room hutches, and that was too big. I had given my son a hutch, and I thought that might work, but it was really too big, bigger than I wanted, but I really liked it. And it was in his basement. I asked him if he was going to use it, and he wasn't sure. And we looked and looked and looked. Then we started looking on Facebook Marketplace. Couldn't find anything. Then we decided to check out Amazon and a bunch of other stores. Well, the prices were $300, $400, up to $900, $1,500. $3,000 was the one I really liked. I'm like, I'm not spending that kind of money, nor do we have it. My show is all about doing things frugally and on a budget. We live on a budget, a small budget. You know, living on a budget could be anywhere from $1 to $1 million, depending on what your budget is. I'm not at $1, I'm not at $1 million. But we don't have a lot of money to work with. Nor do I want to spend that kind of money on something. That's just not me. I like to change things up too much. I don't want to spend a lot of money and then feel guilty I have to live with this the rest of my life because I spent a lot of money. So, with that being said, we were looking and looking and looking, and the next day I got a phone call and I hear, hey, I got some furniture, it's free. If you're interested, come on over and have a look. You got me on free. So I went over and I checked it out, and that cabinet that I have, I love green, that's my favorite color. It fit my kitchen, it's the perfect, it just is perfect. It has the doors closed, I can hide it, it looks pretty. When I open it, it looks pretty. So I'm in the process, as you can see, things are a little messy and not quite organized. We pulled everything out from the cabinets and we are trying to figure out how to best do this. So here's my plan. I want to have a pantry in the kitchen of my everyday things, baking, snacks, breakfast items, breads, all that kind of stuff. Then I want another section that houses the pasta, rice, side dishes, and canned goods. That's the plan. So now I'm trying to figure out between the two places that I have, the new cabinet and, as you saw, my turntable, what can I fit where, what works best. So what I showed you here is what I started with. I've now advanced and I've tweaked it quite a bit, and now I'm labeling things, and you'll see that on the next video. And this will be a three-part series, and then the last one, I'll give you the grand finale, drum roll, and what did I end up with? And now this works for me. You might look at it and say, oh, that would never work for me. That's fine. You know, I'll give you ideas and then you see what works for you. But, so that's what I've been up to with the pantry in the kitchen. I've also been working on my stockpile, which is right behind this wall right here. There's a door right here, and I've shown you my stockpile, but I have been cleaning it out, dusting it out, sorting it out, and yes, getting rid of stuff. And you're gonna say, what are you doing getting rid of food? We're supposed to be storing it up, not getting rid of it. Well, you'll have to stay tuned for the third video in the series as to why I'm cleaning it out, getting rid of stuff. What's the purpose? What am I doing with the food that I'm getting rid of? And why in the world would I do that when I've just told you to build a stockpile? So stay tuned. So I want to just kind of wrap this up today with, okay, now we have been talking about a $5 stockpile. We started out, if you haven't seen that series, I'll link it below. We started with how to build a $5 stockpile. You take $5, five single dollar bills, and every week for 1 month, whether you need a fresh start, you need a brand new stockpile, you've never done it before, or you just kind of got lost in all of this and you want to, what do I do? And, you know, okay, take $5, and here's the categories I recommend. You want a beverage, whether it's a milk, juice, water, whatever you want, a beverage. You want to have a bread category, you want to have a meat category, you want a vegetable category, and you want a miscellaneous. Obviously, beverage, like we said, could be milk, water, juice, etc. Then you want a meat. Well, this is a stockpile storage, so you can't stockpile raw meat, so you're going to have to get canned meat of some sort, or beans if you're a vegetarian, some type of protein, let's say a protein category. Then you have vegetables. You can use vegetables or a side dish, but you could use beans if you want to use that, canned vegetables and things like that. You want to have a bread category, so I picked up pizza crust. Obviously, we can't store a loaf of bread, so pizza crust can make bread. You could do fry bread. You can make biscuits and rolls out of this. Obviously, you can make pizza. We picked up some ramen, so ramen could replace a bread in the bread category. We picked up some breakfast sandwiches over here that have peanut butter already in them, so that could be a replacement for bread. Miscellaneous category, we picked up some Velveeta cheese that we can put over pasta. We picked up some bouillon. You'll want to be able to make soups or gravies or stews. We picked up some fruit at one point. Peanut butter we picked up as a protein. So you can see I've got rice as a miscellaneous. For a vegetable, we picked up instant potatoes. This has cheese in it. It's a four cheese. So here's a great thing. You can't stockpile cheese in your storage. And you know, your storage unit or your closet, but if this comes with the four cheese, you've already got cheese in it, it adds extra flavor. Use bouillon instead of water and you can add flavor to this. We've got canned chicken, we've got some beef stew, we've got milk, we've got water. It's kind of an odd grouping. We've got potatoes and peas, and you might look at this and say, okay, so you spent $5 a week in one in each category, the milk, the beverage, the bread, the meat or protein, the vegetable, and the miscellaneous. So you've spent your $5 a week, it's been a month, now you have your 20 items. And you might look at this, now this is, let's just say this is your first time doing it, and you're gonna go, what am I supposed to do with this food? It doesn't make sense. You're absolutely right. So why would I even tell you to do this? Here's why I'll tell you to do this. You've gotten started and you have a few items in each category. We are building a stockpile. We are not completing a stockpile. Your stockpile is in a constant state of flux. You are building it, you're adding to it, and you're eating from it. So what you need to do now is round out your stockpile. You want to look at this. There are two main things in building a stockpile I would recommend. Number one is, what is your budget? How much can you spend? It might change every week. This week could be $1, next week could be $25. So you need to look ahead and what can I spend when I'm going to, now this is not food that I'm going to eat this week. Okay, this is above and beyond my normal groceries for the week. This is building a stockpile. This is building for the future. All right, we're storing up for the future. So what do you need to round this out? So number one is, how much money do you have? And number two is, what does your family eat? Now, who's in your family? Maybe it's just you. Okay, one person, will you even eat this food? Two of you, three of you, six of you, 10 of you, will you eat this food? Maybe you bought peanut butter and you're all allergic to peanut butter. Or you all hate peanut butter. Why do you have peanut butter? I don't know, it was on sale and I need a stockpile. That's not how you need to do it. You need to buy things that you're going to use. We'll go into that more in the second and the third video in this particular series of the stockpile. You need to round out your stockpile. You need to look at what you have. I have water and I have milk. We really like juice. Well, then we need to pick up some juice. Okay, so for breakfast, I have breakfast crackers here with peanut butter. I have some fruit. I've got milk. I've got peanut butter. What else could I? Well, maybe I need some regular crackers that I can do peanut butter crackers. Or I've got ramen. I really wouldn't want that for breakfast. Maybe I need more fruit. Maybe I need some protein bars. What kind of things can you get to round this out? So now, once you've started at $5 a week, you've done your 1 month, now you need to look at your items and start saying, okay, what are my missing pieces? Again, we're not completing it, we are building it. What do I need to fill in the blanks? And every week, continuing from here on out, you're going to be adding to, kind of rounding out, what can I make out of this? Okay, I have beans and I have rice. That could be a meal in itself. But then I can do beans, rice, and maybe some peas. There's a great meal there. You could do ramen and peas. That would be a great meal. Well, you could do ramen peas and canned chicken. That could be a great meal. Well, this is really good, but you know, I think I might like a dessert. Maybe then you'd want to pick up, everybody needs a snack once in a while. Maybe you want to pick up one of those bags where you just add a little bit of butter or oil and water, the pre-package that comes with the chocolate chips and all the ingredients for cookies. Maybe you want to look for something else. Again, what's your budget? Who's in your family? Do they like these products? Buy the things that they would want so you can round out your stockpile. So next week, we're going to do part two of the pantry. I'll show you me labeling things and how I'm organizing things and how I'm coming along with that. We're also going to be talking about from here what to do on how to eat your stockpile. So now I'm telling you to build your stockpile, not complete your stockpile, but the stockpile is for the future. We're storing up, and now you're telling me we want to eat the stockpile. Yes, we do. And I'm going to tell you, there's a method to my madness on this. When I talk about, we're going to be talking about a 2-week trial period. So come back and get number two. And then the third of the videos in this series will be my final look of my new pantry, how I organized it. I'm talking on a budget, virtually free. What I did, I spent a little bit of money, not much, but what did I do? What did I use? How did I put things in there? A lot of it is recycled items from another cabinet or whatever. You'll get to see what I did. You'll see how I labeled it and what my final look is and why I chose what I did. And then we're going to visit my pantry stockpile behind here, and we're going to clean it out, sort it out, and start getting rid of stuff, and in some aspects downsizing my stockpile, but converting some of it into my pantry. There's a lot involved. That'll be part three of the series, so I hope you come back for that. One other thing I want to show you is I want to show you this jar of pennies. Okay, what is this jar of pennies? You know, we had this coin shortage not that long ago, and everybody was in a frenzy over that. I met a lady today at a conference where I work, and she brought this jar of pennies in, and she says, I want to turn this into a donation toward the ministry here of where I work. That's very nice. Thank you very much. You know, every penny counts. And then she said, let me tell you a few stories about my jars of pennies. And she had this jar, and she said it started many years ago, and she was older. So she was telling me a story of when her kids were just little ones, and they didn't have a lot of money one day, and they needed to get some food and some snacks. The kids were going to camp, and she did not have any extra money at all, nothing. And the kids, but Mom, we got to take stuff. You know, we're supposed to be bringing stuff. She said, I don't have any money. She said, you know what, though? I have a jar of pennies that I've been saving. And both of her kids, like I would have done too when I was a kid, said, what's a jar of pennies? What's that worth? She goes, well, just because you said that, you're both going to sit down here and you're going to roll these pennies and we're going to see how much money we came up with. They came up with $38 from her jars of pennies. $38. Now, this is going back many moons ago, probably 50 years ago or more, that these kids counted these pennies. Well, $38 that many years ago was worth a lot of treats, and they were able to go and get what they needed. And she realized after that, a jar of pennies, really every penny does count. And that's what she's done. She said she just kept throwing pennies in a jar. And time again, she said, I was able to buy things that my kids needed or buy some food that we needed or whatever the case might be. So I just want to encourage you that you don't need dollar bills. You might have pennies. You might have a small jar of change and you count it up and you've got $2.50. Listen, you can buy 2.5 items or maybe 2 or maybe 1 item or something that you can put towards your stockpile. Save your pennies. If you're on a really tight budget, don't stress over this. Just get a jar, start putting your loose change in there. When the jar is full, count it up. Whatever you have, that's the money you can use toward your stockpile. I just appreciated her and her story. She went on to tell me more and more stories of all the things that they've done with their pennies. And it was just a great joy to meet her and to be encouraged by her. So I hope you enjoyed this video. You've got to see the snow here in New Jersey, at least in the area that I'm in. North of me has a lot worse. You got to see the beginnings of my new pantry that I'm creating in my kitchen. We're rounding out our stockpile. Don't forget to come back next video regarding the stockpile, and we're going to be talking about more of what I'm doing in my pantry, and then we're going to be talking about, yes, eating our stockpile. What? Come on back and check that out.